studied. So I'd like to ask you, how did you entirely come up with this idea, and what do you like the most about this project?
Well, after I did Symphonica, I gave the album to Tadia. She listened to it and she liked it. And Tadia also is doing a lot of classical. She's classically trained. She's got a degree in music and she's singing opera and stuff. And then we thought, hey, maybe it's a good idea if we join forces and put a project together where we can, you know, you can sing opera and I can play these classical pieces. And it turned out to be Beauty and the Beat. Mm-hmm. I'm the Beat.
Yes. Yes. So it was her idea to name this project Beauty and the Beat.
I'm sorry?
Yeah, it was her idea to name this project.
No, I named it Beauty and the Beat.
You?
Yes,
oh,
yes.
And one more question, just, you're the first drummer to whom I'm talking actually in my life, and I always wanted to ask a real drummer, how do you think, from your point of view, is the intention of fangirls usually drawn to frontmen and to guitarists and not to the drummers? I mean, because most of the fangirls group is always love frontmen in the band. But I know that you have a great popularity among girls. And,
I do? So, where are the girls?
Well, here I am, actually.
Oh, yeah, okay, you're here. I'm sorry. You are a girl.
So what do you think about the popularity of the different kind of musicians?
You mean why, as a drummer, why do you think that I'm standing out?
How do you look at this? Do you see that you're popular among girls, or you're much?
You know, I don't know. I'll be honest with you. I don't play music to pick up girls. I know a lot of guys do, and it's usually the singer and the guitar player that are combing their hair all day. But I never really cared about that. I grew up on the Beatles, and I saw a lot of, you know, girls screaming for the Beatles, but that's not the reason I wanted to play drums. I play drums because I like it. And actually, the lifestyle of drumming has made me live more alone than ever. Because the problem is a lot of women get jealous that you're playing the drums all day and that you're going away for 2 or 3 months at a time. And for me, the drums are my first love. It's my life. It's my passion. And I don't play for women, I play for myself.
But you don't regret about anything?
I have no regrets, no, not whatsoever. Actually, I'm 55 years old now, and everything that I've done up until this point, I did because I wanted to. I can actually say that. I do what I want in my life. And that might irritate some people, and that's sometimes why I leave a band, or, you know, there's, you hear things about me, but it's like, you have one life, okay? And if you do what someone else wants you to do all the time, you will not be so happy, and they will be happy.
Well, I would have to say probably the Russian women are the best looking women in the world.
Yeah!
They really are. They look good. I was in America and I saw so many people. And those were just the women. I love you. Please, please put down the hamburger and don't touch me. But, yeah, I was scared. I haven't been back to America. I know we got an American guy out there. Maybe later on we can go for some chicken McNuggets. I don't really think there's anything in that food, but it just seems like people are eating and consuming, buying things like iPhones and computers and flat-screen televisions, and then they're eating junk food in their car. And then when they get out of their car, it's like, I love you.
Thank you.
this. We want to hide ourselves, I think.
I'm sorry?
we don't want this. I think everyone...
No, I mean, the thing is, your life is, when you're born, you get a blank book. It's an empty book, okay? You can write the book, or you can give the pen to someone else and let them write it. So I prefer to write my own story. I prefer to do what I think is right. And it's really, I think playing music is a passion, and it's a lifestyle. And I think if you're playing music, especially if you want to be a drummer, a professional drummer, and you're playing for money or you're playing for to get girls, you won't last very long. Okay.
Is it true that when you were a teen, you used to go to many live rock concerts, and that your friends went to the bar saying, "Oh, let's go pick up some girls and drink beer," and you stayed?
That's
and,
true.
Yeah, you were just looking at the musicians.
That's true. Yeah, they thought I was strange because. Well, back in the 70s, we all used to smoke some marijuana, you know, and in between bands, they would go to the bar and, you know, drink beer, look for girls, and I would watch the next band bring their stuff on. I was very interested in how the equipment got on stage, and I was very interested in what the drums were looking, you know, what kind of drums, the equipment. I was very interested in that. I guess you could say I'm a nerd. I'm kind of a nerd, you know.
Drummer nerd.
I'm a drum nerd. Well, I have a degree in electrical engineering, and when I'm home, I'm reading a lot, and I'm not what you think I am. That's the funny thing. I'm completely the opposite of what I am on stage.
What does he want?
They want the simultaneous translation. They want, you will say what, I say what. You say what, I say what.
Da.
Yes.
Da, da, da. I don't know where this is going. Yeah, another question. Yes, sir.
So, this is not the first time you're in Russia.
No.
Can you tell us, like, what you notice about these people and what you notice about our country? Like?
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Wait, can you translate the question? Да, спрашивают, что Майк не первый раз в России, и что он думает о стране, о людях?
Am I gonna go? You ready for this? You translate?
I will try.
Я хочу Москва.
He wants Moscow.
I want Moscow. How do I say I like? I like Moscow. That's what I wanted to say.
Мне нравится.
Easy for you to say.
Нравится.
Sorry. I'll let you speak Russian. You ready? Can you translate this for me? I.
Мне.
Like.
Not. You like.
I like. Russia.
Мне нравится.
I like Russia. I like coming here. I've been coming here now for about 18 years. And it's a pleasure to play here. The audiences are great. I'm not just saying that because this room is full of Russians. But
maybe you attack me if I say I don't like you,
but I like you. And I think that the market is open for rock and roll. You know, I'm from America. I moved to Europe 18 years ago because I was living in Los Angeles, it was very difficult to work. You better translate that.
Ну, ты первый раз здесь появился 18 лет назад, и, собственно, ему здесь очень нравится. И зал полон людей, которые пришли на него, которым не безразлично. Вот, 19 лет назад он переехал из Лос-Анджелеса в Европу, потому что в Лос-Анджелесе банально стал плохо с работой. Yes.
Yeah, so I think there's a lot of beautiful things about the country. It's a very big country. I think the people are very warm. They have a good sense of humor. Really?
Большая страна, в которой люди очень дружелюбные, с очень хорошим чувством юмора.
The food is good. I think the food is good here. Yes.
Еда. Yeah, really. Мне нравится еда здесь.
You know, I grew up, I told some people this today already, but I grew up in 1970-something, and we used to sit in school, and they used to talk about the Cold War.
Он вырос в 60-70-х, и в школе у них была страшная вещь, как холодная война.
They used to talk about the Russians.
Вот то, о чем, точнее, и о русских говорили именно в этом контексте.
We had to be careful.
чтобы быть очень осторожным.
Be careful of the Russians, because they're a world superpower.
Потому что русские очень страшные, вообще это суперсила.
Okay, you know, and I used to hear stories like, you don't want to go to Russia. They just drink vodka and eat sour cream.
Да, ну вообще русские опасные люди, потому что они пьют водку и едят икру.
Yeah, and what's even worse? You know what's worse? Their toilet paper is not smooth.
Да, и не гладкая туалетная бумага.
True. In the 60s, the late 60s, like, oh, in Russia, you don't want to use that toilet paper over there. I'm not afraid, you know. I think, you know, if you really need to wipe your ass, you can use anything. I mean, people have been wiping their asses since the dawn of time. I'm not worried about smooth toilet paper.
It's not easy to play drums in a suit, yeah. Because when you raise your arm, the shoulders go up. Yeah, it's hard. But I think for the beginning of the show, it's okay. Yeah. I try.
Yes, yes. What do you think about women drummers?
I think it's cool. There's a lot of great female drummers in the world, and I really like a lady named Sheila E. You know who Sheila E. is? Sheila Escobedo, she used to play drums for Prince. Mm. Very beautiful, and she can really she can really play drums. I mean, she plays heavy, double bass, Latin. So I don't think it matters if someone is male or female, but it seems now more and more women are playing drums, and it's fun. It's fun to watch. I like it. Mm. It's sexy.
Wow.
It's good. I like it.
Yeah. How are you communicated now with Viktor Smolsky?
We don't communicate. Mm-hmm. I stopped communicating with them when I left about 10 years ago, and I told them what I thought, and they decided to go in the press and say a lot of things that are not so nice and actually not true, but they can say what they want. You know, I mean, I thought that the years we had together, in the beginning especially, were good, mm-hmm. and for some reason things changed, and I leave it at that, you know, but, you know, I think they're talented guys. I don't have anything bad to say about them, but I don't know why they do say such nasty things about me. I think it's a bit childish, but that's how they are. And now the band is broken up. There is no more Rage. I wonder why. Song is
starting playing on drums.
Which song got me playing the drums?
Yes.
I think it was the Beatles, and I started playing drums to the Beatles, Rolling Stones, Creedence Clearwater Revival, a lot of stuff from the 60s and 70s. Led Zeppelin. I remember the first time I heard Led Zeppelin, I was very, very tuned into the drums. I liked it, and I thought, okay. Then I realized I could play a rhythm, and I just started doing it. I played drums for fun when I was a kid. I didn't think about being a professional drummer. Mm-hmm. It's just fun, making noise. And
yeah. What is the most difficult when you play on drums?
The most difficult thing?
Yeah.
I think for me, during the whole course of the day when you're on tour, drumming is the easiest thing to do. I think the hard thing about being in a band is to get along with people, because when you're in a tour bus and you're on tour, everyone has their own individual personality, and everyone has their own idea of what they want. And as we get older, these things get stronger, and then you start to have all this weird conflicts and discussions, especially with music. It goes into all forms. I mean, it's the same thing if you have a relationship, even a one-on-one relationship with a man or a woman. Sooner or later, you start to have a little bit of friction. I don't know why, but that's something I think about. And now I'm running my own band, and I'm the boss of the band, but I try not to tell everybody what to do. I like to talk and let everyone okay, if you want to play, if you want to look a certain way, go ahead, be, express yourself. Because that part of it, getting on stage, is important. And then I think it's very important to communicate. And maybe that's what happened in Rage. No communication. The other problem with Rage is, it's very interesting, is you have a Russian guy, or a guy from Belarus, you have an American guy and a German guy. That's three completely different minds.
Yeah.
Three, we come from three different worlds. Yeah, I'm like more open and crazy, and some people are a bit more quiet and not talking. So, you know, maybe you do something and it offends someone, but they don't say it. If you do that, if you do something, I say, hey, I don't like that. I'm right away, you know? So that could be part of it. But I think that's a difficult thing about being a musician. You could be in the biggest band in the world and not be happy. It's weird. I think it has a lot to do with human nature. It's interesting. But as I get older, I think about this more. But the drumming is easy. That's the fun part. It's all the other stuff that comes with it that gets complicated.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's not so easy. Are very open and sharing information. You know, the guitar player is always like, this is a secret. And there are no secrets with drummers. I was just in Los Angeles and I played the Bonzo Bash, which was organized by Brian Tichy, the drummer for Whitesnake. He's a great guy, totally open. There were so many great drummers there. Carmine Appice, it goes on and on. I can't remember all the guys that were there, but many, many famous drummers. And everyone was watching the other guy play. And we were all smiling. It was fun to watch each great drummer play Led Zeppelin music. Mm-hmm. Okay? And clapping, yeah, it's cool. No one was jealous and, oh, I'm better than this guy. Drummers don't care about that. Yeah. We just kind of share the information. I never get jealous if I see a drummer that's better than me. I've actually done some drum shows. There was a kid by the name of Tony Royster Jr. He's from America. We did a show together in Rotterdam. This was 18 years ago. And Tony Royster Jr. was 12 years old. 12-year-old boy, playing like a man. I mean, he played beautifully. And he's really good. He's playing with a rap artist in the United States. But I wasn't jealous. I was watching him, and I was standing next to his father, and I said, man, this kid is amazing. He goes, yeah, he practices a lot, and he's having fun. And I think music and the art of making music has to be fun. Forget about the egos. Forget about this rock star bullshit. You know, I just read this book on Keith Richards, and everyone says about Keith Richards, he's a sloppy guitar player. You know what? Keith Richards is a cool motherfucker. And you know what he wrote? He wrote, bah, 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 da, da, da. He's a genius.
Yeah.
That riff started a lot of rock and roll, okay? He's a cool guy. He's not concerned about, look at this, I can do this scale or whatever. He just has a drink and smokes a joint and plays his guitar. He's having fun and he's open. He's doing all kinds of music with all kinds of people. And that's where the good stuff comes from. If you're like hating and jealous and look at me and only practicing, you limit yourself to the point where you're not so nice. Nothing comes.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's an exchange. Even when you make music with people, when I'm playing drums, I'm not just listening to me, I'm not listening to me, I'm listening to the band. I'm listening to the guitar, I'm listening to the bass, I'm listening to the singer. Where's all that going? Where do I fit in? That's what makes it beautiful. That's the art of making music, the art of self-expression. And that's what I want to talk about, because there's a lot of guys like, yeah, I'm really good, I'm really fast, I'm really good, I'm really fast. What are you saying? I could talk to you like this, I could just say a lot of stuff, and I could talk really fast at the same time, it's nothing. And that's what people do on their instruments, whether it's guitar. Where's the music? What's important is not the notes, but maybe the space between the notes. That's also music. The silence. That's what creates drama and expression. And the other thing is, when I'm playing drums with people, I'm trying to touch the audience without actually touching them. It doesn't matter if they speak English, it doesn't matter if they like jazz or whatever. They might like a rock song that I'm playing, if I can push it to them. What is music? It's vibrations, right? You ever get, a dog, right? A dog can come into a room and bark at one person. Why? He doesn't like that person because he feels the vibrations from that person are negative. It's the same thing with people. You put a bunch of guys into a tour bus, and one guy's like, I don't like this guy too much. Why? He's some kind of vibration coming up. We're sensitive to that. And that's why I think people go into a room and watch a bunch of guys strum and hit stuff, because the vibrations are good. We like that.
Yeah.
Beach Boys wrote a song, Good Vibrations. Wow. Did I answer your question?
Thank you.
your favorite drummer?
Me? No, I'm kidding. No, my favorite drummer, God. I love so many drummers. Well, of course, John Bonham. Phil Rudd from AC/DC, Terry Bozzio, Tommy Aldridge, Cozy Powell. I could name you millions and millions of drummers. Ginger Baker, Mitch Mitchell, Keith Moon. But there's another guy that I like very much that nobody really knows about, but he's Frank Sinatra's drummer. His name is Irv Kotler. Irving Kotler, amazing drummer. He's an amazing swing drummer. I like Vinny Colaiuta. Dave Weckl, Alex Acuna. You don't even know who Alex Acuna is, but that's okay. He played. Do you know Alex Acuna? He played drums for Weather Report. Do you know Weather Report? No. See, that's what I mean.
Well, if you ask for it, I'll do it. You sure? Yeah. Yeah. Woo! All right. I normally don't do this, but you're such a beautiful audience, I'm going to sing for you. Fly me to the moon. Let me swing among those stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, take my hand. In other words, I love you. I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. I love you.